If you've been trying to get pregnant for some time, but you haven't yet got your big fat positive, you might be starting to worry that something's wrong. But what if I told you that for many, many couples, taking a long time to get pregnant is simply due to a misunderstanding about when you ovulate and when you're most fertile? So today I'm going to bust five of the biggest ovulation myths that could be stopping you, at least temporarily, from getting pregnant. So if you want to find out what they are and how to make sure they're not affecting you, then stick with me for the next few minutes. Hi, I'm Juliette Millar. I'm a trained natural fertility specialist with over 20 years experience, and welcome to Focus on Fertility, the YouTube channel dedicated to supporting you on your fertility journey with science-based tips and information you can trust to help you get pregnant as soon as possible. Okay, before we dive in, let's do a quick fertility 101, starting with what we mean by ovulation. Ovulation is the release of an egg from one of your ovaries, ready to be fertilized by sperm, and it generally happens about once a month. The day that you ovulate in a given menstrual cycle determines the days that you are fertile. These fertile days, the days where intercourse can result in pregnancy, are known as your fertile window. And this fertile window is an absolute maximum of just 6 days long, comprising of the day of ovulation and the 5 days beforehand. But as I said, this is the maximum. Realistically, your fertile window is more likely to be just 2 to 3 days long. And if you don't have intercourse during these days, then unfortunately you won't get pregnant. So if you misunderstand when you're ovulating and misunderstand when you're fertile, it can end up taking you longer to conceive than necessary. And surprisingly, this is really common, and it's why I wanted to do this video, to help you make sure you're getting your timing right. Now, because I want to keep this video as short and concise as I can, I'm going to go through these five ovulation myths pretty quickly. But if you'd like a more in-depth explanation, along with some actionable steps that you can take to boost your chances of getting pregnant, I've created a 5 Biggest Fertility Myths guide, and you can download that for free using the link in the description below. So let's dive in. What are the 5 biggest ovulation myths that could be stopping you from getting pregnant? Number 1, the day of ovulation is your most fertile day. This is straight out false. The day of ovulation is actually the last day of your fertile window. And a number of scientific studies have shown that it's also a less fertile day compared to some of the other days in the fertile window. Not only does sex on the day of ovulation carry a lower chance of getting pregnant, if you do conceive, interestingly, research has found that there's a higher risk of having an early miscarriage. The most fertile days of the cycle are typically the 2 to 3 days before ovulation day. So this is the time you want to get busy. Number 2, ovulation usually occurs on day 14 of your menstrual cycle. How often have we heard this one? For some women, some of the time this is going to be true, but for the vast majority, this is not correct. Very few of us consistently ovulate on day 14. In fact, one scientific study found that ovulation occurs on day 14 in just 13% of menstrual cycles. Even if you have a nice textbook 28-day cycle, you still have only a 10% chance of ovulating on day 14. The truth is, the day of ovulation can vary hugely from woman to woman and from cycle to cycle. It can occur as early as day 8 or as late as day 25 in a normal menstrual cycle. And for women with really long or irregular cycles, it can even occur as late as day 50 or beyond. The day that you ovulate each month will depend entirely on the length of your individual menstrual cycle and the length of your individual luteal phase, which I'll get onto now. Number 3, ovulation occurs 14 days before the start of your next period. Again, for some women, this is going to be true, but for most of us, this is false. The time frame between the day of ovulation and the day your next period starts is known as your luteal phase. And this myth comes from the misunderstanding that the luteal phase is always 14 days long. That's why you might have heard that to work out your day of ovulation, all you have to do is subtract 14 days from the day your next period starts. But this advice is misguided because a healthy luteal phase can actually be anywhere from 10 to 16 days long, depending on the individual person. And although this variation might not sound much, it can make a big difference to knowing when you're ovulating and when you're most fertile. And if you want to know how to find out when you are most fertile each month, regardless of how long your individual luteal phase is, I'm going to do an in-depth video on this in the near future, along with a handy calculation you can use. And I'll make sure to link to this video in the description below once it's done. And if it's not there yet and you're keen to see it, then make sure to subscribe if you haven't already and hit the bell icon so that you're notified when it's uploaded. Number four, you are most fertile when your ovulation predictor kit or OPK gives a positive result. Not necessarily. Remember earlier I mentioned that the day of ovulation is the last day of your fertile window and that it's also a less fertile day? Well, ovulation tests or ovulation predictor kits that measure your LH surge actually turn positive towards the end of your fertile window, just before ovulation, and often after some or all of your most fertile days have passed. So ideally, you want to start having baby-making sex before your OPK turns positive, not afterwards. And if you'd like more information on this and to find out how to best use OPKs to get pregnant, I'll put a link to my free guide on this in the description below. And finally, number five, you ovulate when your basal body temperature goes up. No, that is completely wrong. Your basal body temperature, or BBT, does not tell you in advance when you're going to ovulate or when you're most fertile. By the time you see your temperature go up, ovulation has already occurred, and the egg that you've released has most likely already died or is no longer able to be fertilized. Now, having said that, if you know me, you will know that actually I do highly recommend charting your BBT. And that's because it's a really fantastic tool to let you know if you're ovulating and when you're ovulating. It also helps to provide some other extremely valuable information about your fertility. And I'll be making another video on the benefits of charting your BBT very soon. So that's it for today's video. I hope that's helped to clear up some of those myths you might have been wondering about. And as I mentioned earlier, if you'd like some more information and some simple, scientifically proven steps to improve your chances of getting pregnant, you can download my 5 Biggest Fertility Myths guide for free using the link in the description below. If you found this video useful, please give it a big thumbs up, give it a like, and let me know in the comments which of those 5 ovulation myths you'd understood to be correct until today. And of course, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, make sure to subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. I hope that helps. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in another video soon. Bye for now.